You are looking at a live view of SpaceX's first Crew Dragon spacecraft atop a Falcon 9 rocket awaiting liftoff in just under an hour from now as part of the first crew demonstration mission to the International Space Station for NASA. Good evening and good morning and welcome to the live broadcast of NASA and SpaceX's first crew demo mission to the space station. My name's Dan Hewitt. I'm a public affairs officer with NASA, and I'm really excited to be here at SpaceX's headquarters in Hawthorne, California for today's launch.
Dan, it is so awesome to have you here.
It's awesome to be here.
Thank you for coming. My name is Lauren Lyons, and I'm a senior flight reliability engineer here at SpaceX. And as you can see, NASA and SpaceX have partnered on both the Demo-1 mission and today's broadcast. We'll be bringing you live coverage from not only here at SpaceX headquarters in Hawthorne, California, but also NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, as well as the Johnson Space Center in Houston.
As many of you probably already know, the purpose of today's mission is to demonstrate the ability of SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket and the Crew Dragon vehicle to carry people safely to and from the International Space Station. Today's mission is a test flight. While there are no actual humans on board, we're going to be executing every step of this mission as if there were.
It's worth noting that for purposes of this broadcast, we will be using the terms Crew Dragon and Dragon interchangeably to refer to this next iteration of our spacecraft. The Dragon we fly for our CRS missions has already made 16 visits to the International Space Station, but this is the first time that Crew Dragon is making that journey.
From start to finish, this mission will last approximately 6 days, and it's going to start with liftoff just under an hour from now. Once Falcon 9 has lifted Dragon into orbit, spacecraft will make its way to the space station over a period of approximately 27 hours. This time period's a little bit longer than what we anticipate once people are actually on board, but for this mission, it allows ample time to conduct all the necessary testing and demos prior to SpaceX's first docking of Crew Dragon with the space station.
Once Dragon arrives at station, it's expected to stay for about 5 days, during which time it'll undergo a series of checkouts of many of the new systems, as well as the ISS interfaces. While it's docked, it'll deliver some cargo to space station that we've launched, but it will also bring some cargo back that the crew will pack up in Dragon on the way back home. At the end of that 5-day dock period, Dragon will depart the ISS for a splashdown in the Atlantic Ocean, where it'll be met by recovery crews and transported back to our site at Cape Canaveral.
And for everybody watching and following along at home, if you have a question about this mission or any of the upcoming crewed missions, we'd love to answer them later in this broadcast. You can send them in using the hashtag AskNASA on Twitter.
This is such an awesome and exciting day for the teams both at NASA and SpaceX. And with just under an hour to liftoff, let's check in with the team over in Florida, broadcasting live from Kennedy Space Center.